When did you first hear about the letter last week?
Wednesday evening.
And you spoke with the minister, when was that, sorry?
Wednesday evening.
And the AFP commissioner conversation?
Wednesday evening.
But the PM acknowledged first hearing rumours of the allegations prior to an explosive ABC report in November last year that revealed a toxic culture of sexism in federal parliament.
Did you become aware of those rumours around the same time as that Four Corners Canberra bubble story? Is that when you became aware?
Yeah, but I had no idea what it was about or who it was about.
But so that's the time frame of when you
became aware. What was the nature of the info that you became aware of around that time?
There were journalists asking questions about a member.
For now, the PM is standing by the still unnamed cabinet minister.
Have you asked him if he denies those allegations?
Yes, I have, and he absolutely does.
Last question.
Very sadly,
for this cabinet minister to remain in his position while he has this hanging over his head.
I think it's appropriate for the matter to be dealt with the federal police and the federal police to advise me of the nature of this.
But any prospect of a criminal trial seemingly ended with the death of the complainant last year. No police investigations are currently active, and as the complainant's lawyer suggested in the letter sent last week,
failing to take parliamentary action because the New South Wales Police cannot take criminal action would seem like willful blindness.
I'm not the police force. I have given it to the police to investigate. It's not for me as Prime Minister to seek to interfere or intervene in those processes.
Greens Senator Sarah Hanson-Young is one of the people who received that letter that sparked this crisis along with the Prime Minister. She joins us now. Senator, we'll get to today's events in a second, but just going back to when you received that letter, what was your first reaction?
Well, at first I thought, gee, this must be something quite serious. It came in an express post envelope. It was in another envelope inside of that. It was very hefty wad of papers, 31 pages in total. It was addressed to the Prime Minister, myself and Senator Wong. And in the very first line, it says it refers to the alleged rape of a woman who lived here in Adelaide by a cabinet minister. Incredibly serious. I got on the phone to the AFP commissioner and I reported it. But let me be clear, I then spent the days following reading and rereading and rereading what is in that document. The letter is from friends who appeal to the Prime Minister and Senator Wong and I to do something about this because, just like your package shows, there is no real prospect of a successful prosecution because in New South Wales, the case has effectively died alongside the woman who sadly took her own life. But of course, there is a very serious question about whether this man did it. And if that is the case, should he be holding the post he has in the federal cabinet, a very senior role in the ministry? We need to deal with this. I was just going to say the other element in this package of documents is the effectively the victim impact statement by the woman, written by her, detailing what she alleges happened, and corresponding evidence and diary extracts from when she was 16 years old, detailing that this event, when this event was meant to have occurred.
You've described this as a crisis of integrity. You haven't ruled out naming the accused under parliamentary privilege. What would it take for you to do that?
Look, it shouldn't be up to me or anybody else in that parliament to name the accused. I think it's now really up to the Prime Minister to show some leadership. I must say, though, I was very disappointed with his performance today. He's almost kind of dismissing and disinterested attitude to this. He admitted that he hasn't even read this. He hasn't read the letter, let alone the woman's statement. I think that is just a terrible, sends a terrible sign to and message to women right across this country who are survivors of sexual assault, who have felt silenced, who haven't been listened to, have been ridiculed, have been shamed if they come forward. The Prime Minister, at the very least, should have read this before he came out today. But of course, then the question is, we need a process for dealing with this. It can't be dealt with in the courts. There needs to be a way of dealing with this crisis that is now engulfing the government. And this man might be innocent. If he is, he needs the opportunity to clear his name. But in order to do that, there needs to be a process established, some type of independent review. And, of course, this woman needs her voice heard. So we could do both of those things if there was leadership from the Prime Minister. Or, indeed, if this bloke had any ounce of decency, I suspect, if he really believes he's innocent, then he should step aside, allow a process to unfold so he can have his name cleared and we can put the matter to bed.
So, Senator, let's clear a couple of things up there. You're not going to name him in Parliament under privilege?
Well, I haven't made that decision. I think that's Steve. I haven't made that decision. And the reason I haven't made that decision is because it shouldn't be up to me. We have a Prime Minister of this country. He's the boss of this bloke. He needs to do something about this and take responsibility. But, of course, Parliament is back in 2 weeks' time and the rumours are swirling around who this minister is. People do know. The Prime Minister knows who it is. Many, many other members of Parliament know. It could be anybody
who decides to name him. So if Scott Morrison doesn't stand him down or he doesn't stand himself down, then you might do that. Is that what you're saying?
Well, what I'm saying is that the option is available for any member of the Parliament to take. I hope it doesn't come to that. I hope that the decent thing is done by both the Prime Minister and the man at the centre of these accusations.
Sarah, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Before we leave that story, if it raises any issues for you, you can contact Lifeline. The number is 13 11 14 or 1-800-RESPECT, 1-800-737-732.
You're watching The Project. We'll be back in a moment.